spine.
And there's nowhere I'd rather be than in the stir of the echoes under the ages. Stories of greatness, and I'll never let go till I'm in the pages. Yeah, I'm gonna chase them. I wanna be right there with the heart of a warrior. Right there where the pride and glory are. Time's come now. I wanna be right there in the mind of the fearless. Right there when the end is nearest. Time's come now. Bring me the fire, bring me the war. Give me the ones I came for. Bring me the fire, bring me the war. Give me the ones I came for.
I won't wait my turn. Don't want to be fair. I need you to see. I need you to hear. It's a secret song. It's coming in clear.
And there's nowhere I'd rather be than in the story of the echoes.
Ladies and gentlemen, CAW fans worldwide, we are live here tonight from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, as this is the final pit stop on the road to our next mega event, Cold Day in Hell. Tonight, we welcome you to episode 14 of the Universal Championship Wrestling League. Hello everyone, this is V-Pop here once again as we are ready for another exciting night of action. Like I mentioned before, this is the final pit stop on the road to UCWL's next mega event, Cold Day in Hell. So who knows what's going to happen here tonight, as we're about to run down the entire card for you for episode 14 here tonight. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, PS Power is going to be in action tonight. He's going to go one-on-one, though, with Kyo Kusanagi. Here's hoping Kyo can shut his big mouth here tonight. Also, later tonight in our main event, it's a rematch from Episode 6 as UCWL champion Green Arrow in non-title action will go one-on-one with Mad Max. But ladies and gentlemen, we're kicking things off with a Rise to Glory rematch as number one contender Yuri Boyka faces off against the cyberspace champion Monkey D. Luffy. Let's head up to Shao Curtis for the introductions to our opening contest.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your opening contest for this evening, and it is a non-title bout, except for one fall. Introducing first, from the Thousand Sunny, he is the reigning UCWL Cyberspace Champion, Monkey D. Luffy.
And listen to this ovation, ladies and gentlemen, for the UCWL Cyberspace Champion, Monkey D. Luffy, who at Cold Day in Hell will put that title on the line against Mad Max. But nonetheless, tonight, ladies and gentlemen, he's going to have his hands full as he's set to face off with the number one contender to the UCWL Championship, a foe that he has faced one time before and has actually defeated. But can he do it again here tonight on episode 14?
Opponent being accompanied to the ring by his advocate, Gaga. From Moscow, Russia, he is the self-proclaimed most complete fighter in the world, Yuri Boyka.
And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, the number one contender to the UCWL Championship, the self-proclaimed most complete fighter in the world, Yuri Boyka, who, of course, he's coming to the ring alongside his advocate, Gaga. Yeah, he will challenge the Green Arrow for the UCWL Championship at Cold Day in Hell. But tonight, He's facing off against an opponent who I'm, as far as I know, is the only person on the UCWL roster to actually hold a victory over him. So needless to say, Boyk is going to be out to try to correct that mistake here tonight on episode 14 when these two face off once again. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. And this one's off to a quick start as Monkey D. Luffy catching a charging Yuri Boyka with that neck breaker. And now the Boyka, though, fights back. Big shoulder block takedown. Taking down the cyberspace champion. As I mentioned before, Monkey D. Luffy does hold a victory over Yuri Boyka. These two men fought each other in the semifinals of the Cyberspace Championship Tournament back at UCWL's inaugural Mega Event Rise to Glory. As there you see Boyka countering that scoop slam attempt into a DDT. But a lot has changed since Rise to Glory. I have to say Boyka's more intense and more focused since then. Now look at this. Going to work on the knee of Monkey D. Luffy. And now where's Boyka going? And he falls flat on his face. Boyka, though, got also got a kick to the face there by Luffy. Let's not take anything away from Monkey D. Luffy, though. Luffy is as tough as they come. Oh, look at that. He blocked the spinning savant kick from Boyka. And now look at that. Uppercut there from Luffy. And there's the LOL. But he didn't hang on to it. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Are we seeing it early? We're going to see it early. Oh, look at that. Monkey D. Luffy trying to go for the... Oh, wait a minute. Gaga. Gaga on the ring apron. Ref, what are you doing? The referee just standing in the corner, allowing Gaga to distract Luffy. And allows Boyka to get a second win. And now Yuri Boyka with two and a third German suplex onto the cyberspace champion. Oh, look at this. Oh, Luffy. Nice counter there. And now where's Luffy going? Ah, springboard. A rolling senton did not connect. Oh, this time Boyka catches the spinning savant kick. Could this be it for Luffy? Here's the cover. Two and no. And Yuri Boyka follows it up with a huge knee right to the back of the cyberspace champion. Look at this though. Luffy, nice counter to the arm drag. And a kick of his own. Oh, and Boyka counters with a knee. I was about to say, if anybody can defeat Boyka, it's Luffy, because he's done it before. Boyka, though, with the Russian leg sweep. But look at this. The cyberspace champion back up, and look at this. It's the Mugiwara shuffle. And again, Gaga on the ring apron. Come on, referee, do your job and get him off. Get him off the ring apron. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, Jesus. Luffy was trying to get the crowd fired up behind him, and Boyka made him pay for it with that German suplex off the second rope, and now Boyka's in control of this matchup. Just raining down fists onto the face of the cyberspace champion. Boyka now with that arm breaker. Although that Luffy though, big kick to the knee and causes this as he throws Boyka to the outside. Oh wait, Luffy's gonna fly! Look at that! A suicide dive into a tornado DDT right in front of the Dutch announce table. That's the kind of offense Luffy will do to get the win here tonight. As there you see, he's getting fired up here. Luffy now sending Boyka to the corner. Oh, this Luffy though, what is this? Off the top rope with a huge right hand, and he follows it up with a drop kick. And look at that! Huge moon stomp right onto Boyka. And now, going up to the top rope, and we're gonna see the Gum Gum Guillotine. Whoa! Holy crap! Shades of their match and rise to glory! Two! And no! Boyka, I can't believe it! Luffy was gonna go for the Gum Gum Guillotine. He caught him with a tornado kick in midair. Just like at their match at Rise to Glory. And now, oh look at this. Luffy was gonna go for some kind of suplex, but it was blocked by Boyka. Now look at this, Yuri Boyka. What's this? He's measuring Luffy. Luffy's draped on the bottom rope. Oh! Huge running drop kick right to the side of Monkey D. Luffy's head. But Luffy's back up with a huge shoulder block counter. And now look at this. Luffy again distracted by Gaga on the outside. And Boyka with a side Russian leg sweep. And now, Yuri Boyka. Nope. Counter there by Luffy, the cyberspace champion in control of this matchup. Oh, here we go again. Here we go again. What? Wait a minute. That's Mad Max's music. Oh, wait a minute. Mad Max? What the hell is he doing out here? Mad Max distracting Luffy. What the hell is going on here? Mad Max. Oh, wait a minute. Boyka's back up. Mad Max coming out here and distracting Monkey D. Luffy. And Boyka with the savant kick. Oh, come on. Are you kidding me? Two and... Ah, this one's over. Yuri Boyka capitalizing off the distraction caused by Mad Max to pick up the victory here tonight over Monkey D. Luffy. This match went back and forth all the way to the very end, but I cannot believe it ended the way it did. There you see Boyka with those the triple German suplexes onto Monkey D. Luffy. There's the first spinning savant kick. And Luffy was able to fight back and hit the Mugiwara shuffle. But then Boyka would catch him with that German suplex off the second rope. And then how about this? Luffy with this suicide dive into a tornado DDT. And then, of course, Luffy would do this series of moves right here, that off the top rope right hand, the huge drop kick, and then he'd follow up with a moon stomp. And then he was caught in midair with that tornado kick. But like at Rise to Glory, Luffy would kick out. And Boyka hit this running drop kick. But then Luffy was going to go for the Gum Gum Bullet, only to be distracted by his opponent at Cold Day in Hell, Mad Max. which allowed Boyka to hit that spinning savant kick and steal the victory from Monkey D. Luffy here tonight on episode 14. Nonetheless, Yuri Boyka gains more momentum as he heads towards his UCWL championship match against the Green Arrow at Cold Day in Hell. Ladies and gentlemen, there's still plenty more to come. We'll be right back.
Tried to blame me, but you never paid me, never.
Oh no, you didn't.
Payback is a coming, you will be running forever.
Oh no, you didn't.
Until I get my vengeance, I will never end this mayhem.
Oh no, you didn't.
I'm a mercenary, you ain't got a prayer you owe me.
Oh no, you didn't.
Oh no, you didn't. Oh no, you didn't. Oh no, you didn't. Oh no, you didn't. Didn't you? Oh no, you didn't pay me what you owe me. So now it's over for you.
Yo, yo, check it out.
Oh no, you didn't.
First you try to trap me, then you bust a cap in my ass.
Oh no, you didn't.
Such humiliation will bring annihilation at last.
Oh no, you didn't.
It will be delicious when I get vicious tomorrow.
Oh no, you didn't.
There's no second chances, you will do the dance of sorrow.
Definitely some strong words there from Nathan Explosion as he heads towards his match with Levi at Cold Day in Hell. And speaking of Cold Day in Hell, one of the other matches that we're going to see is a huge grudge match between Daisy Johnson and Bo Dennis. And these women have been in each other's throats ever since they debuted back at DCA's Queens of Wrestling 2. And right now, we're going to take you back to our last episode, episode 13, after Bo Dennis defeated Quiet in her matchup. This was after Bo went on a tirade about not getting a shot at the Call Stars Women's Championship at the upcoming special with the DCA. Colson booked her to match with Quiet. After she won, she went to go use the chair on Quiet, only for Daisy Johnson to prevent that from happening. And right after this incident happened, our cameras caught up with Daisy Johnson, and Daisy had this to say about her upcoming match with Bo Dennis at Cold Day in Hell. Daisy Johnson definitely seems more determined than ever to give Bo Dennis her first loss at Cold Day in Hell. But ladies and gentlemen, yes, coming up next is PS Power. He's going to go one-on-one with Kyo Kusanagi. Who's going to walk out of this one? We're going to find out when these two face off up next when we return.
I can't wait.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is set for one fall.
Welcome back to episode 14 of UCWL, ladies and gentlemen. As there you see Kyo Kusanagi as he's about to enter the ring. This is the first time we've seen him since the six-pack elimination challenge for the number one contendership for the Cyberspace Championship. And right now he's got a huge match tonight as here's hoping he can shut his opponent's big mouth here tonight. Speaking of big mouths, ladies and gentlemen, here is the self-proclaimed intellectual savior of the internet wrestling community, PS Power, who on our last episode openly admitted to claiming that he didn't attack Keith Avicari in his locker room, but he did pick up the scraps like a damn vulture or like a damn hyena. Nonetheless, he's definitely here in action tonight on episode 14. I mean, did you see his last two videos? Did he really call Finn Balor Finn Balor? And Braun Strowman Brown Strowman? I mean, does he know how to pronounce their names? Well, in any case, he's set for action here tonight against Kyo Kusanagi on episode 14. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go with this matchup between Kyo Kusanagi and PS Power. As there you see Kyo taking the early advantage with that snap suplex, taking down PS Power. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I do believe this is PS Power's first match since getting his brains rattled by Yuri Boyka back during the Cyberspace Championship tournament. So you gotta wonder if there's some ring rust on PS Power. Look at that, PS Power though with a jawbreaker on a Kyo. And oh, look at that! He went for a float over neckbreaker, and Kyo countered it just as he was about to execute it into one of his own. And now Kyo Kusanagi, springboard moonsault, taking down the self-proclaimed intellectual savior of the internet wrestling community. Kusanagi now, oh, PS Power with the counter into the shoulder tackle, and he follows it up with that of wrenching the leg there, and now stepping on the shoulder blade of Kyo. Oh, wait a minute, look at that. Oh, what? Oh, come on! PS Power just exposed the turnbuckle, and Kyo makes him pay for it. Here's the cover. Don't tell me, this is... Oh, wow. Okay, that wasn't even two. Kyo Kusanagi now. Big knee to the face. Oh, he missed the kick, though, and PS Power taking advantage of it. And a side Russian leg sweep from PS Power. And look at this, PS Power stomping a mud hole. Probably trying to imitate one of his idols, Stone Cold Steve Austin. You know he loves the Attitude Era. And Keo, though, counters with that arm breaker. But PS Power bringing Keo back into the ring. Look at this, though. Keo counters with that uppercut. And now Keo Kusanagi, big drop kick, sending PS Power to the outside. Well, look at that, though. PS Power with that counter. They're fighting right in front of the Dutch announce table. Keo, though, now sending PS Power back into the ring. Oh, look at that, though. I think Keo is going to go for one of his moves. And PS Power countered, but Keo falls on a counter of his own. And now, Keo Kusanagi, I believe this is the Earl 108 SON. I could be wrong. But look at that combination right there, taking down PS Power. Keo Kusanagi, a very impressive striker. Probably one of the best in UCWL. Which I really can't say the same for PS Power. Look at that. It went PS Power, went for that kick, and Keo countered into a dragon screw. And now, Keo Kusanagi. Oh, wait a minute, are we gonna see it? The 75 Shikikai! That corkscrew kick! Two and no! Somehow, some way, PS Power kicked out of that move. A move we've seen Keo use in the past to put opponents away. Now Keo was going over something. PS Power rolled out of the way, but Keo able to roll out of the move in midair. And he follows it up with that diving, those diving knees into the shoulder blades. And now look at this, trying to go for the submission with the cross arm breaker on PS Power. Is he going to get? No. Somehow, PS Power escapes out of the hold. And there's a right hand from PS Power followed up with that backdrop suplex. Aldo's just hanging out in the corner like all casual. And PS Power follows it up with that DDT. Now what's he going to do? Oh no, Keo counters. And now here's the cover from Keo. And again, not even two. Now Keo with the head scissors. But PS Power manages to escape out of it. Huge right hand there from PS Power. Falls up with the elbow. And a huge clothesline. And now what's PS Power doing? I love this. PS Power going to with those right hands to the face of Keo Kusanagi, and he follows it up with that forearm. PS Power, I gotta admit, he's definitely a student of the game. He definitely has some moves. Not very much, but he has some. Kick to the face there from PS Power. What's he going to do here? Another side Russian leg sweep on Keo Kusanagi. Now what's he going to do? And, well, hanging out in the corner look at this. Keo, 88 Shiki, can he nail the last kick? And there's the kick to the face. Oh, the PS Power counter with the jawbreaker. But wasn't enough as Keo, oh wait a minute, look at this, PS Power countering the kick into a dragon screw. We saw Keo do that earlier. This has actually been a very competitive matchup between both Keo and PS Power, which I kind of hate to admit. PS Power with a kick just above the area you're not supposed to kick. Alright, look at this though. Keo, right hands, and a boot to the midsection, sending PS Power to the corner. Oh, wait a minute! PS Power just put the referee in the way. The referee is down as he's going to work on Keo. And now the two are fighting back. Oh, wait a minute! It's Keith Abicary! Keith Abicary with that right hand just as the referee comes to. And now Keo! Here it comes! 75 Shiki Kai! Again with that corkscrew kick! Here's the cover! Two! And Keo's got him! To be honest, I don't think Keo needed the help of Keith Abicary to win this. But nonetheless, that's what happened. As here we take a look at some of the action from this matchup. How about this? The boom! That huge counter from Keo, which led to this combination move here. The series of strikes. I thought for sure it would have ended right there, but it didn't. This is the first 75 Shiki Kai that Keo tried to get the victory with. But PS Power shocked everybody by kicking out of the move. Of course, PS Power would fight back with that clothesline. And then Keo would hit the 88 Shiki. The series of kicks, followed by the one of the face. But then PS Power would try to use some dirty tactics by pulling the referee in the way, but it backfired completely as Keith Abicary showed up to get some payback from the few weeks ago. As there you see Keo hitting the 75 Shiki Kai for the second time in this matchup, and this time he got the victory. And a big victory here for Keo Kusanagi. Who knows what's in store for him here in UCWL. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Keith Abicary's not done. He brought PS Power back into the ring. And now look at this. Keith Abicary getting some payback on PS Power for a few weeks ago. Keith Abicary just hammering away on PS Power and a huge right hand. Keith Abicary taking his frustrations out on PS Power. Now look at this. Now both men brawling here. Both men brawling as here comes security. Security bringing up both these men. And ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. We'll be right back.
this is going to reignite the era of wonder.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live for the Royal Rumble.
Levi is definitely determined to defeat Nathan Explosion in their match at Cold Day in Hell. In any case, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to show you some footage from some house shows. As General Manager Phil Coulson mentioned, the Cruiser X Division is getting its own championship, and there will be a fatal four-way ladder match at the upcoming head-to-head special with the Destiny Championship Alliance. And there have been a series of qualifying matches that have been happening at some house shows. This is the first one from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, as there was a fatal four-way match putting Hollywood Adonis Creed, Parco Fulgore, Kung Fury, and Jago against each other. As there you see some of the highlights from this matchup. And of course, the winner of this matchup will become the first entrant into that fatal four-way ladder match for the Cruiser X Division Championship at the head-to-head special. As there you see, how about this move from Jago right here, leaping over Parco Fulgore to deliver Hurricane Rana to Adonis Creed, but nonetheless, it was right here, Kung Fury with that running knee, and he would pick up the victory and become the first man to qualify for that ladder match at the head-to-head special. Then at the second house show in Perry, Oklahoma, we had another fatal four-way match, this one putting Dom Pierre, Ezra Bridger, Yaiba Kamikaze, and Nova against each other. And this was a hell of a match between all four of these men. And how about this? There you see Nova with that deadlift German suplex onto Dom Pierre. Then there was that kick there from Ezra Bridger. This match could have gone either way. I thought for sure there were definitely times I thought Nova was going to win this matchup. But it was right here, Yaiba Kamikaze taking advantage of the situation, hitting that discus forearm with that cybernetic arm, while Ezra Bridger and Dom Pierre were fighting on the outside. Ezra tried to come in too late, and in the end, Yaiba Kamikaze would become the second entrant into that fatal four-way ladder match. So there you have it right now. Kung Fury and Yaiba Kamikaze will be in that ladder match to determine UCWL's inaugural Cruiser X Division champion at the upcoming head-to-head special with the Destiny Championship Alliance. Who else is going to qualify? Well, we'll find out in the weeks to come to see who will join both Kung Fury and Yaiba Kamikaze. But ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. Coming up next, the Cruiser X Division stars will be in action as once again, another Cruiser X Division star is going to make his debut. Don't go anywhere, where we'll be right back with Cruiser X Division action.
Yeah.
ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is a Cruiser X Division match and is set for 1-4. Introducing first, from Nagano, Japan, Tachiru Tsunami Kobayashi.
And welcome back to episode 14 of UCWL, ladies and gentlemen, as we're getting set for some Cruiser X Division action, as here comes the Japanese eating machine, Takeru Tsunami Kobayashi, who, of course, this is the first time we've seen him since that six-pack elimination challenge on the pilot episode previewing the Cruiser X Division. This will be Kobayashi's first singles outing, so we're about to see what he's capable of one-on-one with his opponent here tonight on episode 14. Making his debut tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is Georges Batroc, aka Batroc the Leaper. Of course, the only thing I know about him is that he is a master of the deadly French martial art known as Savant. So needless to say, this is definitely going to be an interesting matchup between him and Kobayashi here tonight on episode 14. Just look at that intense stare from Batroc. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. It's a Cruiser X Division match here tonight between Takeru Kobayashi and the debuting Batroc the Leaper. And Batroc did a backbreaker, then went for a quick cover, only for Kobayashi to kick out. Although that went for some kind of back suplex, but Kobayashi lands on his feet. Big knee to the midsection, but it seemed to have no effect on Batroc. Batroc went for the scoop slam. It's reversed. Kobayashi now. What's this? Big power bomb there from the Japanese eating machine. Now, ladies and gentlemen, both of these men will be involved in those qualifying matches to crown the inaugural Cruiser X Division champion at the upcoming DCA versus UCWL head-to-head show. As there you see Kobayashi fighting out of that hole. I'm about to say right hands from Kobayashi, but look at that! Big forearm there, and another stiff kick there from Batroc the Leaper. And look at this. Look at those elbows right to the side of the throat of Kobayashi. And look at that. Kobayashi, though, escaping out of the head scissors. But look at this, Batroc. No, the kick is blocked. And a huge sidewalk slam there from Takeru Kobayashi. Kobayashi now, wait. What the? Did Kobayashi just puke on Batroc? Well, Batroc's making it pay for it with that lumbar check. I cannot believe Kobayashi just did that. He actually puked on Batroc the Leaper. I guess he ate too much before this match happened. Now Kobayashi though with the elbow, no, jawbreaker from Batroc. And now Batroc the Leaper, what's this? Fireman's carry into the backbreaker. And now Batroc on the top rope. And he connects with that diving knee right to the forehead of Takeru Kobayashi. And now another lumbar check. A second lumbar check from Batroc the Leaper as he's now wrenching the neck of Takira Kobayashi. Kobayashi in a lot of trouble here. Batroc now seems to be stalking Kobayashi, waiting for him to get up. And a huge kick right to the back. Oh wait, look at this. Kobayashi counters with the dragon screw. And now look at this, Kobayashi, spinning back kick. Sends Batroc into the ropes, big drop kick. And another one. And a swinging neck breaker. Kobayashi on a roll here. Oh wait. Oh, he did it again! He did it again! He threw up on Batroc the Leaper, and Batroc is pissed about it. Big right hand. And there's a third lumbar check. A third lumbar check from Batroc. As you see Kobayashi, I can't believe he threw up on him. Here's the cover. Two and no. Batroc able to kick out. Oh, huge shot to the midsection. And now Batroc, what's this? Fireman's carry again into the backbreaker. And now he's going up to the top rope. What is this? And he's just standing on the top rope. And I guess he had second thoughts. I don't know what he was going to do there. But look at this. Inverted suplex there from Batroc onto Kobayashi. And a big knee to the midset. Knee and a huge axe kick to the back of the head. And now Batroc, what's he going to do now? Again, waiting for Kobayashi to try to get to his feet. Well, look at this. Kobayashi playing possum. Hit him with that arm drag, follows it up with that DDT. And now Kobayashi on the middle rope. Measuring Batroc the Leaper. Huge axe handle off the second rope. Kobayashi down, no. Counter there by Batroc. Batroc down, what's this? Backdrop suplex, oh, he hangs onto it. And a second backdrop suplex. And a third one turns into a German. And now, Batroc going to the top rope. Oh, what is this? What is this? Oh! Double foot stomp right to the chest of Kobayashi, and this one's over. Batroc the Leaper, very impressive in his in-ring debut here tonight as a member of the Cruiser X division. As here we see some of the highlights from this matchup. How about this? I can't believe not once but twice Kobayashi threw up on Batroc in this matchup. As Batroc hit that knee, diving knee off the top, Kobayashi tried to fight back with these series of drop kicks that proved to be somewhat effective. And then he threw up on him a second time. Of course, Batroc would fight back with that lumbar check. And he followed up with that fireman's carry into the backbreaker. And then how about this? These two backdrop suplexes that he would turn into a German for a third one. Which then he would follow up with this huge double foot stomp. And I'm being told, ladies and gentlemen, ironically, he calls that the leap. That's right, Batroc the Leaper finishing off Takira Kobayashi here tonight with the Leap.
Here is your winner, Batroc the Leaper.
Again, an impressive victory here tonight by Batroc the Leaper, and we'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Well, how about that, ladies and gentlemen? It looks like we got our main event for the pre-show. Android 13 taking on a new acquisition that UCWL has signed. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, as mentioned by General Manager Colson, the card for Cold Day in Hell has been finalized. It is set, and we're going to run down the entire card for you, starting with this match that was just made earlier tonight by General Manager Phil Colson. That's right, it's going to happen at Cold Day in Hell. We're going to see PS Power go one-on-one with Keith Abicary. Needless to say, this is going to be probably a slugfest between these two. And who's gonna walk out of this one? I have no idea. Is it going to be the self-proclaimed intellectual savior of the internet wrestling community, or is it going to be Keith Abicary? Of course, the other match we got is Nathan Explosion going one-on-one with Levi Ackerman. We heard from both men earlier tonight. Both of these men seem determined to walk out of Cold Day in Hell with a victory over the other. And you gotta wonder what's gonna happen when these two finally face off one-on-one in Austin, Texas. And then we got, speaking of a grudge match, how about this one that's been brewing since episode 2? It's gonna be Jack going one-on-one with Skeletor. Needless to say, both these men have been involved in each other's businesses for the past several months, attacking each other in the locker rooms, in the hallways. Needless to say, it's going to come to a head when these two face off finally at Cold Day in Hell. Then we got the mysterious Hell's Kitchen Street Fight. That's right, it's now a Hell's Kitchen Street Fight between Chef Gordon Ramsay and Iron Chef Morimoto. You gotta wonder what's gonna happen when these two face off in this very unprecedented matchup. Who's gonna walk out of this street fight intact? We're gonna find out at Cold Day in Hell. Of course, the UCWL Cyberspace Championship is gonna be on the line as well, as Monkey D. Luffy puts his title on the line against Mad Max. Earlier tonight, we saw Mad Max cost Luffy a match to Yuri Boyka. Is Luffy going to get some retaliation when these two face off for the Cyberspace Championship? We're going to find out at Cold Day in Hell. And speaking of retaliation, you want to talk about bad blood? How about this one between Daisy Johnson and Bo Dennis? What a match this is going to be between these two. These two have been wanting to face each other again ever since they fought at DCA's Queens of Wrestling 2 late last year. Will Daisy give Bo her first loss in CAW, or is Bo's undefeated streak going to continue? And then, of course, we got two of the biggest matches on the card. The first being the 10-team Tag Team Turmoil match to crown the inaugural UCWL Tag Team Champions. The thing is, we only know half of the playing field. The Sith Lords, MI-13, the Wing Commanders, the Reactors, and the Black Dragon. Who are the other five teams going to be? And which one of these 10 teams is going to walk out of Cold Day in Hell as the inaugural UCWL Tag Team Champions? Only one team is going to make history in this at Cold Day in Hell. And then there's the main event as well. The UCWL Championship will be on the line as the Green Arrow defends the UCWL Championship against the self-proclaimed most complete fighter in the world, Yuri Boyka. It seemed for weeks Boyka was destined to become the new champion, but Green Arrow may have found a crack in the armor of Boyka. What's going to happen when these two face off? We're going to find out in just a few weeks' time. Well, and speaking of the Green Arrow, ladies and gentlemen, he's going to be up next in non-title action in our main event when he faces off against Mad Max. That's next when UCWL returns.
Why is Video Game Wrestling Network the only network for...
It is free!
Oh, stop! Oh, my God!
Why is the Video Game Wrestling Network the only network for...
Start it off! Oh! Out of nowhere!
Don't fall on the steel. Oh, my God! Oh! Superplex! What a brutal match. We have just seen.
Why is Video Game Wrestling Network the only network for...
Daniel Barza?
Oh my god!
This is gonna happen.
BSKO, there it is! He charges up! He goes over the top! Spider-Man!
Why?
This is the only place we want to be.
Video Game Wrestling Network, the only network for you. Experience the best in CAW wrestling. Only on Video Game Wrestling Network.
Contest is your main event of the evening. It is a non-title match except for one fall. Introducing first, from the Australian wastelands, he is the Road Warrior, Mad Max!
And welcome back to episode 14, ladies and gentlemen, as it's main event time, as here comes the number one contender to the UCWL Cyberspace Championship, Mad Max. Of course, this isn't the first time we saw Mad Max tonight, as earlier tonight, he cost the Cyberspace Champion, Monkey D. Luffy, his match to the number one contender, to the man he's going to be facing right now, Yuri Boyka. Now we're going to see just how well Mad Max can handle himself in a rematch, so to say, against the reigning UCWL champion here tonight. The UCWL champion, ladies and gentlemen, the Green Arrow, who at Cold Day in Hell has a date with the most complete fighter in the world, Yuri Boyka. But tonight, he's going to have a bit of a rematch here, so to say, from all the way back on Episode 6, as he faces off against Mad Max here tonight on Episode 14. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. And look at that, Green Arrow right off the bat taking the fight to Mad Max. As I mentioned before, this is not the first time both men have faced each other. As a matter of fact, they faced off against each other back on Episode 6. This is back when Mad Max was first revealed to UCWL as the Pick Your Poison opponent, picked by Nathan Explosion to face the Green Arrow. Of course, a lot of people were shocked to see Mad Max come to UCWL. There you see Green Arrow hit that springboard moonsault onto the Road Warrior. And look at that. It's moves like that that makes the Green Arrow the UCWL champion. A hip toss into a neck breaker. But it's moves like that that make Mad Max just as dangerous as he is able to counter into that short arm clothesline. And Mad Max, huge left hand punch to the side of the face of the Green Arrow. As I mentioned before, both these men have huge matches heading into Cold Day in Hell. Of course, earlier tonight we saw Mad Max, like I mentioned before, we saw Mad Max cost Monkey D. Luffy his match to Yuri Boyka. You're going to wonder if that's going to come back to bite him in the ass when these two face off at Cold Day in Hell, as the Green Arrow with that double foot stomp right into the chest of Mad Max. Now Green Arrow, look at this suplex attempt here. No! Mad Max counters into one of his own. And now the Road Warrior going to work on the Emerald Archer. And look at that, Green Arrow countering with that shoulder thrust. UCWL champion now with Mad Max, sending Max into the corner. Oh wait, are we going to see it here? We are! There's that springboard enziguri that the champion likes to use. And now the Emerald Archer trying to get this capacity crowd to rally behind him. You gotta wonder though, has Green Arrow found a crack in the armor of Yuri Boyka? Wait a minute, look at this. Are we gonna see it? Yes, we are. There it is, the Queen's Gambit. This could be it right here. And surprisingly, Mad Max kicks out at two. And wait, no, Mad Max. That judo arm throw there. And again, shoulder block there by the Green Arrow. Oh, and look at that. Mad Max saw the enziguri coming. And Mad Max counters into that swinging neck breaker. But look at this. Green Arrow back up. Snapmare by the UCWL champion. And he follows it up with a neck whip. And now, here's the cover. Two, and no. Now Mad Max able to fight back to his feet. Oh wait, look, no! Nice counter there by the Green Arrow. He was gonna go for that spine buster that normally sets up for that spinning sidewalk slam, but Green Arrow saw it coming. And there's another enziguri. Green Arrow with another springboard enziguri. And now he could be setting up for a second Queen's Gambit. Mad Max in a lot of trouble. Here it comes. Queen's Gambit. No! Mad Max counters. Mad Max countering the Queen's Gambit into a short arm clothesline. As there you see a shot of this capacity crowd as they're really getting into this matchup. And now the Road Warrior following it up with that Shinbreaker. And Max, no! Again! Shoulder block there by the Green Arrow, followed by a stiff kick to the chest. And another spinning wheel kick there by the UCWL champion. Green Arrow now. What's he gonna do here? Nice Hurricane Rana there by the champion. And now, Green Arrow. Snapmare takeover into the rear chin lock. Trying to wear down the Road Warrior. But look at this though, Mad Max fights back with that wind-up punch there. And now the Road Warrior. No! Blocked there by Green Arrow. And now the UCWL champion on a roll here. Green Arrow now. What's he gonna do? Nice swinging neckbreaker there onto the Road Warrior. Mad Max in a lot of trouble now. More right hands there by the UCWL champion. No, that now they're blocked. Now it's Mad Max in control. Kick to the midsection by Mad Max. What's this? Oh, look at this. This is a very rare move. We see that. That's a Canadian style backbreaker. But look at that though. Mad Max couldn't keep his grip as Green Arrow is able to slip out of it. And Green Arrow sends Mad Max to the outside. Green Arrow sending the Road Warrior to the outside. Mad Max now slowly getting to his feet. This capacity crowd really getting to this matchup. Whoa, wait a minute! Look at this! Monkey D. Luffy! He came from underneath the ring! And look at this! Luffy! Fighting Mad Max all the way up the entrance ramp. This is a bit of a retaliation from earlier tonight when Mad Max cost Luffy his match to Yuri Boyka. And now, the cyberspace champion and the number one contender to that title fighting their way up the ramp here. Yeah, I'm being told, ladies and gentlemen, this match has been thrown out. As Luffy and Mad Max are now fighting up the entrance ramp here. Oh, what a fight it's going to be between these two for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Cold Day in Hell in Austin, Texas. As Mad Max hammering away on Luffy. And now Mad Max. No, Luffy fighting back now. Now these two are fighting up on the entrance stage. Luffy getting some payback from earlier tonight. Oh, what a kick there by Luffy, taking Mad Max off his feet. And these two now continuing to fight on the stage now. Oh, wait a minute! Meanwhile, back in the ring! Where the hell did Yuri Boyka come from? Yuri Boyka surprising the Green Arrow. Oh, look at this, Boyka. This has been the MO of Boyka for the past several weeks, assaulting the UCWL champion. And now look at this. Boyka now he's trying to choke out the Green Arrow with this rear naked choke now. Oh man. At the rate this is going, Green Arrow, I don't think he's gonna make it to Cold Day in Hell. Oh, wait a minute! Green Arrow able to fight his way out of that rear naked choke! And now he's starting to fight back! Oh, but a strike there by Boyka! And a a huge running kick. Boyka now in control. Oh, the tornado kick. Well, wait, look at this. Green Arrow. He's back up on, he's, again, another tornado kick. But again, Green Arrow will not stay down. Green Arrow, not, and this time Boyka with the savant kick. And now Boyka seems to be measuring him, and a third tornado kick. And this time the Green Arrow looks like he's out cold. Oh man. Ladies and gentlemen, oh god. Now the referee. And now Boyka takes the UCWL Championship. Is this a sign of things to come? Is this a glimpse into the future? Ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time we have. We'll see you all in Austin, Texas for Cold Day in Hell.